Hello and welcome back to the DoneDeal YouTube channel. Today it's nice and rainy for a very special review as we've got the Mini John Cooper Works. Now, some of the stats on this is 231 brake horsepower, it's front wheel drive, it's got an 8-speed automatic Steptronic gearbox, and it's quite light, around 1200 kgs. Now this shape Mini, believe it or not, has been around 20 years, and that's a long, long time. However, the original Mini was actually around for 40 years. So let's take a trip down memory lane at the original Mini. It all started in the late 1950s when the British Motoring Company decided to build a car that was not only spacious on the inside, efficient, but also that would fit inside a container that was 10 foot long by 4 foot wide and 4 foot high. They hired Alec Isogonis, who had previously been involved in designing the Morris Minor. After many failed attempts, he had a breakthrough. If he turned the engine sideways, he could make a front wheel drive, and then it would easily fit 4 adults. These must have been some very small adults, because as today's standards go, it is pretty mini in here. Anyway, in August 1959, the Mini hit the market and immediately sold several thousand off the bat. Things got very interesting in 1961. The Mini entered the world famous Monte Carlo Rally. It did terribly. It only had 34 brake horsepower and it actually ended up crashing. Despite the crash, the Mini showed superb potential. With the front wheel drive, it gripped in these snowy and tough conditions very, very well. And with having the wheels in each individual corner spaced out, it handled phenomenally. It was actually so good that one very important man expressed quite a lot of interest. And that important man was none other than Mr. John Cooper of the Cooper Motor Company. He approached Mini in 1962 and said, "Hey, I can help you guys." At the time, he was quite an important figure in the motorsport industry, thanks to his rear engine chassis design that would go on to revolutionize motorsport at the highest level. With Formula One and Indy 500 cars quickly adopting to his work, he managed to convince the British Motor Company to let him tune one up all the way to 75 horsepower. Then they took on the Monte Carlo and they won it in 1964, 1965, and 1967. Now, Mini were hesitant to put it into mass production as they thought they'd be lucky to sell 1,000, and in the end, they actually sold 125,000.
And if that number doesn't impress you, then what will is that Mini went on to sell over 5.3 million original Minis, 1.6 million of which were actually sold within Britain. Fast forward to 1994, where the now Rover Group was acquired by BMW. They almost immediately got to work on designing the new Mini, the one that we see on the roads today. It hit the market in 2001, and just like its predecessor, it was a massive, massive hit.
So that is the story of where the Mini has begun, and it has so much heritage and history. So now let's check out where we're at in 2020. That leaves us to here on a cold and rainy autumn's day in the Dublin mountains. So we're going to run through the outside of the John Cooper Works really quickly because I do want to get back inside and use the heated seats. First thing you'll notice, as a whole, it's a lot more aggressive, it's a lot more beefy than your normal Mini. It also has a few fake things which I'm not a huge fan of, things like a fake bonnet scoop. One of these is actually completely filled in, the other is an intake for your intercooler. These cool racing stripes. You've got a red roof, red wing mirrors. From the rear, you've got this really nice spoiler, which does actually have its uses, and we'll talk about more of that in a moment. Also, you've got these twin exit exhausts in the center, lights, and you've got these black wheels. Now, I kind of feel like these are just the normal Mini wheels, and they were like, oh, we gotta make the wheels look cool. And then someone went in and sprayed them black with a can. But other than that, It looks really, really good. Now let's take a look at the inside. Oh, it is miserable out there. Now, on the interior, these seats, first thing, they're absolutely striking to drive. They're not only comfortable, but they make you feel really secure and really solid on the road. Everything else in here, I mean, it's just like any other Mini. The steering wheel feels good, driving position's good. You've got all your usual tech, one upgraded system in this. You've the sat nav and the Apple CarPlay. It's wireless Apple CarPlay, which is a nice, nice touch. That will cost you an extra 1,400 euros. However, that's one of the upgrades I definitely tick. And other than that, it's very similar to the normal Mini. So I'm gonna suggest having a look at our Mini Cooper Electric video, as that's gonna have all the insight in terms of boot space, rear space, and all the different kind of storage units and that. But for now, let's do the fun part and take her for a drive. To drive, the John Cooper works. Now, I could talk about what it feels like driving it around town, but the reality is, if you've come this far in the video, you're probably more interested to know what it's like as a hot hatch in its true essence, in its true form, and it's good news. So, as I'm sure you're well aware, Minis are known to handle like go-karts, and this John Cooper Works is no exception. The biggest elephant in the room, or the stigma against this particular one, is that it has an 8-speed Steptronic automatic gearbox. Now, what that means is it makes it a lot easier to drive, but it could arguably take a lot of the driving pleasure out of it, as you're not shifting, and that is one of the most glorious parts about driving a car on some nice roads. I will say it's very, very good. However, I maybe would actually spec it without that, as it's definitely nice just changing gears yourself. The next thing to discuss is power, and it's got plenty of it. 231 brake horsepower, to be specific, out of the now 2-litre engine. It'll do 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in 6.3 seconds, but that doesn't really matter, because if it had any more power, the wheels will just spin up. For example, now, if I knock it into second and I put the foot down, you will kind of find yourself fighting for traction. And that's kind of one of the things I'd like to discuss as well. So it's got Pirelli P0 tires on it. Fantastic tires. However, in Ireland, when you've got a bit of rain and moisture on the roads quite often, maybe something like a Michelin Pilot Sport 4S would grip ever so slightly more. Now, of course, most importantly, when it comes to driving any Mini, handling. How does it handle? Well, the good news is it handles exactly like a go-kart, and it handles as it should. The center of gravity is low. And honestly, and this will pain me to say it, but I think it grips better and is more planted than the king of hot hatches, the Golf R. And I'm seriously not joking. It is incredible. The rear end is so light. The whole car weighs about 1,200 kilograms. And the back end, when you come into a corner and you put your foot on those big brakes, it actually starts to lift a bit. And that's where that rear spoiler is actually essential. It gives you some amount of downforce when you take a corner at any sort of speed. And trust me, you need it, despite it being a front-wheel drive car. Now, I know I said the handling was the last thing I'd discuss, but I can't do a review on this car and not mention the noise, the exhaust, and it sounds really, really good. So when you actually do a downshift, you'll get a little pop, a little burble, which is quite nice. One kind of drawback is on the upshifts, unlike a DSG or a DCT, you don't get that fart as you kind of go through the gears. However, I think all in all, it sounds very well. There is an option to get an active exhaust where you have a valve in your remote control to open it, and that is definitely worth getting, as I've been in a John Cooper Works with that, and it's just a laugh driving it. You're literally driving it, and the pops and the bangs, you just can't help but smile. It is such an enjoyable car to drive. It's literally a toy. It's just fun to drive. It just makes you laugh. It makes you grin from ear to ear. And it just promises you a good time without being overkill. Well, there you have it. That is DoneDeal's review of the Mini John Cooper Works. And we've also taken a bit of a walk down memory lane into the history and exploring the heritage of Minis. Now, this John Cooper Works comes in at about 43,000 euros. However, I reckon if you were to buy it and store it for another 60 years, you'd probably get your money back and some. That is it for this video. We hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like to see Minis for sale at the moment in Ireland, you can hit the link up here. And in the meantime, if you could subscribe, that would be fantastic. And we'll see you in the next one.